So we're on chapter 5, section 5, and we're going to talk about two different kinds of organic reactions, and those are condensation reactions and hydrolysis. So when I say the word condensation, I bet you think about a glass of like iced tea on your counter, and water starts to condense on the outside of your glass. And that's a good representation of what we're thinking of, because it's not the scientific definition, but in the scientific definition for a condensation reaction, when two organic molecules are joined, that joining releases a molecule of water. And so think about condensation as making water, as water being produced on your glass, same sort of deal. So anytime we have functional groups that have a hydrogen that's polar, the molecule's polar, so that hydrogen is partially positive, right? And then it has an OH, and that O is partially negative. And so they're attracted to one another, and those two groups, you can remove one hydrogen, and then one oxygen and one hydrogen, and you can make water, right? Because water is H2O, so you need two hydrogens and one oxygen, so you can make water. So if you look here, here's an example of a condensation reaction. What you have here is any old molecule. We're just gonna put an R there, right? So we have two R groups. So we have two molecules. Each of them is composed of something, so the rest of the molecule, and then we have an OH. And then our next molecule, we have that same R group, so it's a bunch of stuff, and then we have an OH. And so we don't need both oxygens in a condensation reaction. In a condensation reaction, you take an oxygen and a hydrogen from one, and you take a hydrogen from the other. And so what you're left with is this oxygen right here that is going to bond with your other R group over there. And so now you have your two R groups. So we have a blue R group and we have an orange R group, and they are linked together by that oxygen. And then what happened with the rest of this is that we have one oxygen molecule, one hydrogen. And so with that, we can make H2O. So a condensation reaction occurs when you have two small molecules. So here's one, here's two, and we form a larger one. And so there's always going to be an oxygen in between those in a condensation reaction. So the opposite of that is a hydrolysis reaction. Hydro meaning water, and lysis meaning break. And that means that we're going to break water, or we're going to consume water as a reactant in order to break a large molecule into two smaller molecules. So it's the same reaction, right? Except we're going in the opposite direction. So here we have water, and we have this great big molecule here, right? It still has R groups. I should have left that, right? And so what happens is that this water will break apart and actually go in and add to the two different sides of that oxygen atom there, and you will essentially break the molecule on one side or the other of the oxygen. It doesn't really matter which one. I'll show you some examples. And you end up with, here's my blue R and here's my red, my orange R, right? And so now I end up with two smaller molecules, right? So condensation and hydrolysis are basically opposites of one another. So they're very, very common in biochemistry. They happen a lot in organic systems. One example is the hydrolysis of ATP. This is ATP, adenosine triphosphate. So we call it triphosphate because we have one, two, three phosphate molecules, and it undergoes hydrolysis where we break apart water in order to break the ATP apart. And in this case, the oxygen that we're looking at is this oxygen right there. And so what's going to happen when water breaks apart in order to break this molecule is that we're going to pop off the end phosphate group and we're going to add an alcohol to it, an OH. And so what we end up with is adenosine diphosphate, di meaning two. So we only have two phosphates now. And so this is just another example of hydrolysis. And then the reaction can go in the opposite direction, right, where we produce water in order to make ATP from my inorganic phosphate, so one phosphate group, and the ADP molecule. Okay, so they go back and forth. Carboxylation is a reaction that involves the addition of a carboxyl group or a carboxylic acid group. So when we talk about carbon and oxygen, right? Right, that's our carboxylic group. It has carbon and it has oxygen in it. And we have a lot of carbon dioxide that actually moves around in the cell, and we can use it to kind of shuttle around carbon as we need it. And so you can add groups of carbon and oxygen to small molecules, and you can remove them. And so that reaction is actually catalyzed by two enzymes. The adding is called a carboxylase. Remember, ASE means an enzyme. Carb here is for carbon, and oxy is for oxygen. So in this case, we're going to add carbon and oxygen. Decarboxylase means we're going to remove. D is remove. The carbo is for carbon, oxy for oxygen, and then we know it's an enzyme. So decarboxylase is going to remove carbon and oxygen. So if you kind of look at the name, you kind of know what's going on. So here's our example where we convert pyruvate to oxaloacetate. And that happens through pyruvate carboxylase, right? This is the enzyme we were talking about, carboxylase. And so what actually ends up happening is that we have that this condensation reaction, because here's an OH and here's a hydrogen. And those two are going to come off and come together to form water. So now you kind of got to think about the rest of the molecule. So what's going to happen with the rest of the molecule is right here, this stuff, this carbon bond right here is now going to move, and this carbon bond is now going to be a bond to this carbon right here. And so what you would do is you would get rid of this, right? And then you would write carbon, and that carbon's bond to an oxygen, double bond to another oxygen. And so what you can see is you now have 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons in your chain. Now let's come over and check our answer, right? This first carbon right here is this first carbon right here. Do you see how they just arranged it differently in the formula than 2, 3, 4? And so our answers match up. So just sometimes the book will do that where they kind of turn the molecule just to make it kind of easier to type out, but the reaction is exactly the same. We're just drawing it differently. All right, so adding and removing, when we talked about that phosphate group, right? Adding and removing a phosphate group is one way that we can regulate all kinds of chemical pathways. And you can turn things on, you can turn things off by adding and removing that phosphate group that we removed before. And so we call these reactions phosphorylation, where you add it, and dephosphorylation, where you remove it. So this is phosphorylation is an add, dephosphorylation is a remove. Okay. And so they are really condensation and hydrolysis reactions, right? And it makes sense that we're going to name these enzymes that make these reactions happen phosphorylases, right? So that's going to be your condensation reaction, and where you add the phosphoryl group, and then you'll have enzymes that catalyze hydrolysis, so removal. Those are going to be phosphatases. So when we look at this, what we're doing here is we are removing our phosphate group. So this is a dephosphorylation, right? So we're going to consume water. We're going to break apart water, because what we want to do is right here, we want to break off our phosphate group from our R group, right? We have our R and we have our oxygen. So we're going to break apart water. And so what's going to happen is this R group with the oxygen is going to pick up a hydrogen. And then this phosphate is going to pick up the other oxygen and hydrogen. And so that's exactly what we see here. We see ROH, and then we see our alcohol, our OH, and then we have P, and then we have our oxygens around it. So this is very similar to what we were just describing. So then we're going to talk a little bit about lipids. So when we talk about lipids, there are some lipids that are hydrolyzable and there are some that you can't. So a hydrolyzable lipid will react in a hydrolysis reaction, right? Just like we've been describing before. And then there are those non-hydrolyzable lipids that just can't do it. They can't undergo hydrolysis. And so the hydrolyzable lipids, which include waxes and fats and oils, they contain the ester functional group. So here's our ester functional group. Remember our ester, we have a carbon double bound to an oxygen, then an oxygen, and then we have that, that R group. So they have this ester, and this ester can react with water. And when it reacts with water, what it's going to do is it's going to form a carboxylic acid and an alcohol. So these are the hydrolyzable liquids. And so what you're going to see is that water is going to break apart, right? And you're going to add a hydrogen to one group, and then you're going to add the remainder OH to our other group. And so we end up, because you added that OH, that's an alcohol, right? And now we have a carboxylic acid group on our other molecule, where we have a carbon double bond to an oxygen with an alcohol. And we call that palmolic acid. All right, let's see, last one. So a lot of our fats and our oils can be hydrolyzed into the things that make them up. So we know fats and oils are fatty acids and glycerol. So glycerol is our head groups, right? Our N, so here's glycerol. So this is the separate molecules down here at the bottom. We have our glycerol, and then we have our fatty acid here, right? We talked about fatty acids in the last chapter. And so the way that we can break apart a fat is we can look at our glycerol. Here's really it's right about there. That's what is going to turn into our glycerol, and the rest of it is what's going to turn into our fatty acid when we undergo a hydrolysis reaction. So hydrolysis reaction, just the same way that we've always talked about, we're gonna take that water, we're gonna break apart that water, and when we break apart that water, we're gonna go and kind of attack that oxygen bond to the carbon, and we're gonna split these molecules in half, because the glycerol heads will pick up the hydrogens, and then the fatty acid tails are going to pick up the alcohols. All right, so let's go try a couple of problems. So what kind of a chemical reaction is hydrolysis? Is it synthesis, decomposition, or exchange? So you got to remember, what does hydrolysis mean? Hydrolysis means water is going to break, or E-A-K, break up, right? And when water breaks up, right, you're gonna have that one molecule. Remember, it kind of started out like this. And so the water is gonna come in and it's gonna break those bonds. And so what you're gonna end up with is one of the R groups, right, having a hydrogen, and then our other R group, right, is gonna pick up the OH, which is gonna end up like that, right? So we went from basically one molecule to two molecules. And so that must be a decomposition reaction. All right, let's see. Oh, and I'm supposed to be doing the odd numbers, right? No, yeah, odd numbers. Why do I always get mixed up on that? Anyway, draw the products for the ester that is formed through the condensation reaction shown. So you know from this reaction that you are going to make water. So condensation, make water. All right. So we know that we're going to make water, so it's going to be basically the opposite of what we just drew up here in 5.35. We're going to go the reverse direction. So what we're going to do is we're going to see our OH here and our H here. That is what is going to come together in order to form water. All right, so we know one of our products is going to be water, so we can just write that. That's condensation. So here's the oxygen, here's the hydrogen that we're going to use to make water. So what we do is just write your substance, right? So I wrote all of this, and now I'm going to take this carbon, and I'm going to link this carbon to this oxygen. So there's my oxygen, and I'm going to finish that molecule, CH2CH3, okay? All right. Oh, and that's it. All right. Have a good rest of your day.